sky, some say the moon. Why choose this as our goal? And they may well ask, why climb the highest mountain? Why 35 years ago, fly the Atlantic? Why does Wright play Texas? We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other thing. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because that goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills. Because that challenge is one that we're willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one we intend to win.
Work.
No comment.
You should get a job you like talking about.
I just don't like talking about work at home. That's what I do all day at work.
It was getting cold.
I know.
You okay?
Yeah. We have to start eating better.
What's wrong with this?
Your butt's getting fat.
My butt's not fat.
It's not toned.
Yeah, but it's not fat.
It is, actually.
I don't see it.
You don't see your butt.
Well, yeah, but, like, considering I don't work out.
Can we stop talking about being fat?
I'm saying I'm not fat. That's my argument.
Have you told your brother you're coming?
He's my stepbrother. No, I haven't told him.
Neil?
Hmm?
I love you.
I love you too. Where are you going?
To bed. I'm really tired.
You want the rest of your food?
I'm not that hungry.
Oh. Good night.
Neil Henderson? Jared Connors!
Yeah!
From middle school!
Middle school. Yeah, that was fun.
Yeah.
Wow, you've grown up. That's cool.
But you know, puberty will do that, huh?
Right.
But you, I mean, you look the same. I recognized you right away.
Yeah, well, puberty. Still waiting on it. Over here.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm just gonna get this, so.
Oh, now, hey, man. Now, I know the holidays are lonely, but I hope you're not gonna drink that all by yourself, right?
That's actually from Mom, so get that out to her, because it's getting late.
Yeah, so.
Hey, babe. Sorry I didn't wake you up this morning. You were sleeping really hard.
Was I snoring?
No, you weren't sleeping that hard.
I found something on the counter.
Did you like it?
You know I don't have pierced ears.
You don't have pierced ears?
I let them close up after I read that National Geographic article
about the Africans who stretch their
earlobes.
Yeah, it's not really the same thing, though.
I can't help imagining
earrings slowly stretching out my lobes.
I think I threw away the receipt, but maybe you can re-gift them.
Why didn't you call me when you got there?
Right, well, first, I didn't get here with all my bags. And then I went to get another present from my mom, and I ran into this guy I knew from middle school or something.
So you don't have anything?
Nope. Damn. Hold on, I need clothes.
Those would be in your bag, Neil.
Let me call you back.
Yeah, bye.
Oh.
What?
Yeah, never mind. I'll just ask you later.
Ask me what?
Just what you wanted for Christmas.
Oh.
Instead of earrings. But I'll ask you later.
Okay.
Okay, I love you.
Bye.
Bye.
Neil?
Hey, Travis.
Why are you here?
Surprise.
You haven't been home in like 6 years. Is Mom asleep?
She's not asleep. Not really.
What's that supposed to mean? If she's not asleep, then where is she? Mom? Her car's here. Where is she?
Travis, she's dead.
Why would you say that?
Tonight. She died tonight.
What are you telling me?
She was dead on the couch when I got here earlier. They said it was probably a heart attack.
Right there?
Yeah.
Where is she?
She's dead.
No. Where's the body?
I don't know. I guess the morgue? They left some paperwork. They said they'd call in the morning.
You gotta be kidding me. I just saw... talk to you right now.
Do you want some breakfast?
There's no food in the house.
Travis,
Sorry.
This was heated.
It is. You have to turn it on first. Travis, we need to talk.
Okay, come on.
You lie about there not being any food. The milk was bad, but that was it.
That's just because you don't live here anymore. You never want what you already have.
Want one?
It's nicotine gum.
You want one?
That's a stupid sweater. You should have called.
You're probably right.
I'm not probably right. I'm right. You should have called. She's my mom.
What?
Neither of your parents live here anymore. She was my responsibility.
She's a grown woman. She's not anyone's responsibility.
She was an alcoholic. Why you left?
No. I got a job.
You got a job, moved away, and you never looked back. You ever heard of a phone?
Yes, I've heard of a phone, Travis. I'm not a caveman.
Then why didn't...
No. No. I get it. So what the hell are we gonna do about Mom?
You mean like with a funeral?
It's Christmas. Nobody's gonna come.
We could wait.
Can't. I told the police to leave right after Christmas.
What'd they say?
They didn't really care. They pretended to care because of the circumstances, but they didn't really care.
Well, they're probably closed.
The police?
No, the funeral people.
Aren't there a lot of deaths at Christmas, though?
Are there?
I don't know. Maybe they're just the ones you hear about because they're sadder.
I don't really know what you're talking about. Are we gonna bury Mom in the backyard?
Like the dog?
Well, it's what she wanted.
No, she wanted to be cremated.
Cremated?
I thought so.
When did you have that conversation?
When did you have the conversation about burying her in the backyard?
Probably at some point in the past 6 years.
You've grown up.
I think cremation takes longer.
Really? I don't know why. All you have to do is burn the body. You don't have to worry about like the preservatives or whatever.
Can we talk about something else, please?
Yeah. You're right. Sorry. Look, I'll let you make the calls and the arrangements and everything, but if we're gonna have a ceremony, it needs to be tomorrow.
How are we gonna do that?
Pay him some of the life insurance money.
Who is it?
It's Tara.
Who's Tara?
My girlfriend.
Did you tell her?
Not yet.
What is your deal, Neil?
It's just, you start to tell people and it becomes this big deal.
It is a big deal.
I just don't want people talking about us in reference to our mom dying. You know, for the next few years, everyone's gonna look at us and say, oh, those poor kids, they just lost their mother. That's gonna be us.
God, you make it sound like you're so inconvenienced by this.
I am.
God damn it, Neil. Aren't you even the slightest bit sad?
Just let me deal with it my own way. I don't need this. I didn't come home for this.
And what did you come home for?
Nothing.
You should call her back.
Hey.
Hey, Mom. It's me. Travis. I miss you. I wish that I could have done more for you. Though I'm sure you would have said I'd done enough. I'm sorry. I wish I could have said goodbye. The end.
I didn't have anything prepared. I didn't know we were doing this. But I guess I would like to say I'm sorry, Mom. You made it.
I'm so sorry I'm late. I would have called, but my phone died.
It's okay.
Are you okay? How are you?
I'm fine.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
I'm Travis, Neil's stepbrother.
Tara.
He gave a really good speech a minute ago.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I could read it again.
No, I think that would weaken it.
I'm sorry, boys. I've got to get going. I need to prepare for the evening service. I'm really sorry for your loss.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Thanks, Father. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Father. There are drinks inside if you want one for the road.
Thank you, Neil.
Hi. I'm Tara.
Well, y'all take care now.
So what do you want to do with the ashes?
You want to keep them?
I don't think so.
The lake?
Water's kind of low. But yeah, I suppose so.
So we just gonna dump it right here?
Are we sure this is what we want?
Yeah.
Okay, then.
Should we say something?
We kinda just did that.
Huh. Right.
Okay. But... Oh yeah, no, I think it still counts. All right. On three?
On three.
One, two, three.
What the hell? You said on three.
No, it's supposed to be one, two, three, and then go.
So you go on four?
No, no, it's the pause after three.
That's four. You never go on four. You're supposed to go on three, like you said.
We had one shot at this, and you screwed it up.
Let's just do this.
No, no, you're kicking the ashes.
Does it really matter if they're here or there? The wind is just gonna disperse them anyway.
Shit.
So, this is our house.
Like this?
I think so.
What's in here?
Nothing.
Sorry.
That's my dad's workshop.
When do we get to see your room?
I was kind of hoping you'd forget about that.
Part.
All right. Come on.
Tell me something.
Like what?
Like about this. You never tell me anything. I want to know about all this.
It's old news.
It's you, though. You know what I think? I think that maybe if you were an astronaut, you wouldn't hate your job as much.
Yeah, it was a tough choice, actually. Insurance or space exploration?
You could sell space insurance.
And travel shuttle to shuttle.
Or planet to planet. Or... you could still go door to door and sell to normal people just in case they're ever in space.
We need to go. I'll be in the car.
I don't want to.
You should go. And so should I. I have to be home in time for Santa.
You're not staying?
Neil?
Travis.
Travis. You must be Neil.
I am. Neil.
Sorry about your loss, boys. Especially around the holidays, I know it's tough.
Oh, Neil usually isn't home for the holidays. So I don't think it's so hard on him.
Well, let's just get down to brass tacks, shall we? I have your mother's will here. That she made after her first heart attack.
Excuse me?
Your mother's will.
Now, what about her first heart attack?
You... you didn't...
He never called.
She had a heart attack 9 months ago. Neil, I think you're gonna wanna hear this. Please. Sit. Your mother left everything. The house, her savings, everything your father left behind. To the both of you. Complete 50-50 split down the middle.
50-50?
Is that okay?
That's no!
Fine.
No, you don't understand. Neil hasn't been home in like 6 years. He doesn't deserve anything. She wasn't even his real ma.
Well... obviously, she thought differently. And I suggest you both go by her wishes.
Why the hell didn't you tell me about Mom's first heart attack?
What difference would it have made? Would you have come home then?
Probably.
Okay, so it's only convenient for you to come back after near-death experiences.
She almost died and you didn't tell me.
She did die and you didn't tell me. You just went to sleep. Why the crap did she leave you half of everything?
Because I'm just as much a part of this family as you are.
She wasn't your mom.
It was all Dad's money, but you don't see me complaining about that.
He left.
He left us with everything.
Not everything.
Just shut up, Travis. How are we gonna split everything?
What?
How are we gonna split everything? I'm talking to you. Damn it.
Can it both?
And the living room!
It's 50-50, I get half of it.
Swimming pool!
Hot tub.
Damn it!
Huh. And we get to keep our rooms, they already are.
What else is there? No. No, no, no! Stuff in there. We each get half of his intellectual property.
That only applies to the stuff he sold. I got this room fair and square.
Fine. I got everything else.
I get the hot tub. And my room.
Hey.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Did I wake you up?
No.
Yes, I did. You know you can't have the golf clubs unless you call them.
Golf clubs.
That doesn't count.
Why do you keep wearing that stupid sweater?
Because it's Christmas. It's the only time of year the sweater gets to be worn.
Well, I still think it's stupid.
Do you want to do something today, since it's Christmas and all?
Like what?
I don't know. I was going through Dad's old stuff.
You know, it doesn't even feel like Christmas.
I know.
I think before we do anything, before we do anything, we should put up some lights or something.
Yeah, why didn't you guys decorate this year?
House is too big. Mom didn't feel up to it. You know, I was gonna put up the Christmas tree last night, you know, Christmas Eve and everything, but well, that didn't work out, did it?
Let's do it.
You mean right now?
Why not?
Okay. Lights are in the downstairs closet.
Overloaded it. We must have blown a fuse or flipped a breaker or something.
What's the difference?
I don't know.
You remember when you used to play hide and seek down here?
Yeah. It was only good when you played with new people though, because once they figured it out, they'd lock you down here.
You locked me in for 3 hours one time.
It wasn't 3 hours.
3 hours, 12 minutes, and 47 seconds.
Oh, you timed it?
I was stuck down here for 3 hours, 12 minutes, and 47 seconds.
Okay, but you didn't know you were being stuck down here when you got down here.
Well, that's what I remember.
So what I'm saying is you wouldn't have known the seconds.
I think this is it. Nothing.
No. Nada. No.
Did you know there's a door over here?
Where?
I don't know where it goes.
Maybe it's a secret room where Joseph's been hiding all these years.
That's not funny, Travis.
I'm sorry. You're right, I didn't mean to sound like something he'd really do. This might be it. What is it?
She's Dad's garage again.
Wish I'd known about this when we were playing hide and seek.
Guess he wanted to make sure we stayed out.
Hey. You know what would be cool?
What's that?
What if we put the spaceship back together? You know, just for the hell of it. All the parts are here. Sort of. You know, we'll make new ones. Come on, you're always into this sort of thing.
I don't know.
Let's do it. Let's build a little spaceship in the backyard.
It wouldn't be very little.
What do you think?
Well, I have to make a lot of modifications to the design. The propulsion system never really worked.
It doesn't have to work.
You want me to do it or not?
Yes.
Okay. Let's build something moon-worthy.
What's first?
Research.
Empty this.
Neil Henderson?
This is he.
I got your suitcase.
I thought you guys lost it.
Yeah, well, they're never really gone for good.
Oh. Well, I'll be right up.
Sign here.
Okay.
You, building a bottle rocket or something?
Yeah.
Yeah, I did that once in school.
Oh, this isn't for school, though. This is for real.
This is dangerous enough as it is. You need your protective eyewear. Once you provide pressure, that thing's gonna go sky high and fast. No time to play around. Are you good? All right. Brace yourself. Launch.
You forgot to put water in it.
What?
Based off my initial calculations, one of two things will happen. It'll take off, or it will explode. Also, we need more money.
Well, we kind of have it.
Just making sure we're on the same page.
You know, it's kind of cool how this has turned out. I wish everything in life was this easy.
You think this is easy?
Oh, relative to building a real rocket. Relative to building a multi-million dollar NASA rocket?
I could build a better rocket than them.
You know, this is the last thing I remember Joseph doing. You know, spending weeks out here building the spaceship. I didn't understand it at the time. But I guess it's one of those things you don't really think is strange until you're older.
It really wasn't all that strange, all things considered.
How do you mean?
Well, you're just doing something he's really passionate about. He conquered all his ambitions.
Well, what does that mean for us? Were we not a part of his ambitions?
I don't know the answer to that.
Well, you gotta imagine, it must have been pretty hard to have left us behind. And go do whatever it is he's doing.
We don't know what he's doing. Or if he's even alive.
I don't care anymore. You know, I sometimes wonder if this whole spaceship thing wasn't just some elaborate stunt.
No way. It was way too elaborate to be a stunt. He really wanted to build a spaceship.
Well,
what?
Well, I think what he really wanted to do was impress you. You know, because you love space stuff so much.
How do you mean?
I think he wanted you to believe that he actually went to the moon.
I was 14.
That's what Mom thought.
I believe that on some level, you really want to get to outer space.
Yeah, but that doesn't justify what he did.
Maybe it does.
Okay. Why'd you leave?
I told you. Got a job?
You could have gotten a job here.
Yeah, you know, I wasn't so comfortable here. I need a new situation, change.
I think maybe Dad thought the same thing. Building spaceships better than selling insurance?
I don't know yet. I'll have to tell you after we've built one.
Yeah, but so far.
So far, it's pretty good.
Shit's here.
What about the ship?
I said shit.
No, shit.
Yes, shit.
No, it's probably Tara.
What?
I haven't spoken to her in like 2 days.
How often are you supposed to speak to her?
Hey.
I thought you'd be home by now.
Yeah, well, I did too, but believe it or not, I've actually been really busy.
Too busy to call?
No, just involved in something.
Too involved in something to call me and let me know what's going on?
Too involved in something to call you and let you know what's going on? Yes. But I'm sorry. It wasn't on purpose.
What have you been doing?
Oh, you know. Not a lot.
You just said you were busy.
Yeah, well...
Why won't you tell me?
It's not important.
It's important enough to keep you from calling me back or coming home?
Tara, what's wrong?
I'm on the side of the road with a flat tire and I'm fucking pregnant.
You said you were pregnant?
Yes.
Fucking pregnant?
Yeah.
That was mine.
Travis, I have to go.
Where?
I have to go home.
For what?
Emergency.
What emergency?
She's pregnant, Travis.
Tara's pregnant?
Just told you that.
And you didn't know about it?
Oh, no. I knew about it. I just now decided to start freaking out over it.
Well, we'll just have to finish when you come back.
Yeah, I don't know that I'm coming back.
You have to come back.
Having a baby.
In like 9 months.
I got a lot to do. I have to get a better job. I have to get married. I can't just screw around with these spaceships.
This is a terrible reason to get married.
Well, we were already thinking about it. Of course, now, people are probably gonna think that the pregnancy is why we're getting married, aren't they?
It depends.
What do you know?
Well, I know that you haven't been back in this house in like 6 years. And you couldn't stand being here for 4 years before that. You know, after Joseph left.
All right. Bye, Travis.
And for the first time since we were kids, you seem excited about being in this garage again. That's all.
I said bye.
Wait. Does this mean I'm an uncle?
Step uncle.
So I guess since you're leaving, I'll just have to finish it by myself.
Don't touch it.
What does it matter? You're not coming back.
Don't touch it. It's not yours to touch.
You can't tell me what to do. As soon as you walk out that door, I get to do whatever the hell I want. What are you doing? Come on, you can't take them.
Why not? I made them.
You're being unreasonable.
And you're being an asshole. Travis, let go.
No.
These are my plans.
What are you possibly gonna do with them?
Keep you from messing with the ship? Like, damn it, Travis.
I can make do with this.
Give me it.
And when you come back, we'll combine our two halves, and then we'll get back to work.
Fine.
Wait. Nice. No, really, that's...
Oh, perfect. Oh, great.
What do you think you're doing? Neil!
It's like I told you, leave the ship alone. Forget about it.
Forget it? It's a huge mess in the yard.
Baby's head makes up 50% of its weight. Some things to expect when you're expecting. When a baby is born, it will not know how to speak. You will be able to teach it a language eventually, but for the first 9 months to a year.
The Best Thing About Babies by Dr. Kelman.
So, what is the best thing about babies?
Hasn't said.
Don't you think you're a little early for all this?
No.
I always thought the best way to learn was through, like, you know, firsthand experience.
Well, I guess we're gonna get to. I would have told you sooner. I was in denial at first. Then your mom died and we were both with our families. I didn't know what to do.
Hey, you did fine.
How does it make you feel?
Like one of those typical teenage pregnancy stories you hear about? You know, how irresponsible of them. Naive, horny little kids having sex. Something like that.
Are we young enough to be naive about this?
Well, we're not teenagers anymore. So I guess not. I guess we just kind of did it.
Yes, we did.
Thank you.
You still have this?
This is my Cosmos 800X. What would I have done with it?
Apparently nothing. What are you looking at?
Just stars. Started building a spaceship.
What does it look like?
Right now it's not too much to look at, but it's gonna be, you know, your average 15-foot silver bullet.
I wanna see it.
Yeah, well...
What?
I kind of stalled its production. Tore up the plans. Attacked it with a board.
Why?
I don't think Travis should be working on it without me.
I don't understand. You can't go back and finish it.
No.
How come?
This is what I need to be working on right now. This is my responsibility. This is the real world.
I don't want to have a baby with an insurance salesman.
Well, it's too late for that. I'm off to bed. Got work in the morning.
Well, that's the story, Neil.
It's a nice shirt, Ted.
Thanks. It's from my mom.
Tara? 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 Quit my job. Travis, it's me.
If it's Neil, hang up.
Hey, Mom.
Travis?
Travis, what's going on? Is that Tara in the background? Put her on the phone. I need to talk to her.
I wasn't expecting you for a couple more hours. Did you quit your job or something?
Didn't call.
She made me take an oath.
So we gonna do this?
You didn't quit your job for nothing.
Well, I didn't quite quit officially. Sort of left.
So, I fixed the plans.
Yeah, I'll probably still redraw them.
Right. Of course. Yeah, I just... You know, I had a lot of free time. And,
We still need a few important components for the insides. First off, particle accelerator.
Do you guys have any particle accelerators?
I don't think so.
We're also gonna need a G diffuser. How about a G diffuser?
No.
And most importantly, we're gonna need an alpha exploder.
Surely you have an alpha exploder.
Are you guys sure you're in the right place?
Where's the plumbing section?
aisle 4.
That's it?
We're gonna have to improvise with plumbing supplies.
Is there anywhere else you can go?
This will work.
Did you know an astronaut's heart is smaller in space?
Is it because they're completely alone in a vacuum of darkness?
No. It's because there's no gravity. It doesn't have to work as hard.
Yeah. I guess this will be easier in space.
We need to have a baby in space.
Huh, that'd be a pretty terrifying experience. Maybe it comes out floating around, still attached by the umbilical cord.
Why would it still be attached by the umbilical cord?
I don't know. Just how I imagined it.
I guess it'd be like an astronaut then. So is this an original recipe?
Mostly.
Have you considered culinary school?
I don't want to be a chef.
What do you want to do?
No idea. I mean, I have a few ideas. Mostly about what I don't want to do. But mainly no idea.
So Neil, are we almost finished with the ship?
We're still on schedule to launch New Year's Eve. I figure that's the best time to get away with a loud bang.
Yeah. You know, we ought to have a big party.
You're anticipating a bang?
Only it's a spaceship, so I'm assuming there's gonna be a bang of some sorts. Why?
I don't know. Guess I hadn't really thought about it. What all are you expecting it to do?
We're gonna have a full-on test, you know. Pushing the big red button.
I still have to paint that.
And what color is it now?
Blue.
Oh yeah, that'll never work.
So the button won't cause the loud bang?
We don't know until we push it.
What else would it do?
What do you want to do?
Nothing.
Why would we spend so much time on something that's going to wind up doing nothing?
I don't know. For fun. To fuel your love of moon stuff.
Fuel probably isn't the best word.
What good does it do to build a vessel to explore space if it's not going to help you explore space?
Apparently it doesn't do any good.
I don't get it. What'd you think we were doing?
Exactly what it looks like.
What's that supposed to mean?
I'll talk to her. I'm pretty sure the spaceship doesn't work.
What?
I'm on your side. I don't think it works. It's made mostly of metal, wood, and old electronics. There's nothing really in it that it can explode.
Then how do you explain what Neil just said?
Get in the hot tub.
I'll talk to him.
My hot tub.
Well, that was my dining room we just ate in.
Lasagna was good.
by the way.
Thanks. Yeah, I'll bet Dad never even used this hot tub.
You calling him Dad again?
Maybe I'm starting to feel a little bit closer to him.
Well, he had underwater inventions too. We used to test them in here.
I don't remember that.
Too hot?
Too hot. Here.
Is this Mom's?
Yeah. You saved it. Thought maybe you could use it.
You didn't want it?
I'm not about to get married like you are.
Yeah, but she's your biological mother.
Yeah, but it was given to her by your biological father.
You know, they make pretty good brothers. Under the right circumstances.
I think that means we're not very good brothers.
What are we then?
We're stepbrothers. Like we've always been.
I can live with that.
Shit. Did you drop it?
Why'd you give it to me in the hot tub?
I held onto it fine.
Come on in.
You want me to hold onto it for you?
No. It's not that hot. It's the wind.
I hadn't adjusted yet.
Thanks, Travis.
You're welcome.
What are you doing?
Checking out the inner workings.
Oh.
Don't break anything.
I won't. You know, it's really incredible, Neil.
What?
The ship. I like it. It's impressive.
Oh, well, I mean, I copied my dad's old design. Using a lot of old parts.
I know. I just wanted you to know that I like it.
Okay.
And I'm sorry that I tried to spoil it for you.
What do you mean?
Nothing.
Tara? Will you marry me?
Are you serious?
Dead serious.
Where did you get the ring?
It's my mom's.
My God. Really?
Yeah. Travis gave it to me.
Just now?
Yeah, in the hot tub.
Is that why you're doing this?
No. Just hold on. I'm sorry. This is your Christmas present. Your real one, I mean. I got it before I left. But my mom's is probably nicer. It's definitely more expensive, so I guess you could pick one.
Can I have both?
I suppose. Hold on. This. You know, you're probably the only girl in the world with two engagement rings.
From the same guy, at the same time. It doesn't really fit.
Yeah, sorry, I didn't have time to resize my mom's.
It's okay.
Tara, you haven't said yes yet.
Yes.
So, congratulations.
For which thing?
Both, I guess. So, I guess this means you'll be my sister-in-law.
Technically, step-sister-in-law.
Right. I was only able to get a handful of friends to come over tonight. They didn't already have plans.
That's okay. It can be an engagement slash New Year's slash lunch slash I'm pregnant party for a complete group of strangers.
You know, it feels like I was just doing this.
Diet Coke or anything?
I think we're out.
You know, you're not supposed to be drinking that.
It's grape juice.
Sneaky.
Thanks.
I feel awkward here. I'm not really a people person.
I know. But Travis did this for us.
They're all his friends, though.
That's all he knows.
Wants to know more about the spaceship.
Damn it.
Oh, hey, Neil. So, what's it supposed to do?
The spaceship?
Yeah, the spaceship.
What do you think it's supposed to do?
Like a real spaceship? I guess I would say it's supposed to go into space.
Bingo.
Do you really think it's gonna work?
It's supposed to, but you can't go around judging things by what they're supposed to do, can you?
Yeah, I guess that's right.
So, you're planning to go to space tonight?
Yeah, maybe, if I get drunk enough. Well, I'm gonna go get another drink.
Thank you.
Watch out.
What does it do?
I don't know.
You know, I used to think that fireworks were actually magic. You know, packaged in a way that normal people could use them. Now, wizards and stuff, they could make fireworks come out of their hands. But the rest of us, we just had to go buy fireworks and light them ourselves.
Yeah, I kind of used to have a lot of ideas like that. I don't remember them anymore.
So we're gonna save the big one for last?
This one?
No, I mean that one.
Oh. I don't think so.
I thought you said tonight was the best night for it.
Nah, we don't have a full moon.
What do you need a full moon for?
Yeah, it's kind of cloudy.
Are you speaking of metaphors? Look, I only invited everybody because I thought it was a big deal.
No, it's okay. We have plenty of stuff to celebrate tonight.
When I first suggested that we rebuild the spaceship, I was expecting it to only take an afternoon.
I'm sorry?
No. I'm glad it took longer.
It was a good one.
Not a good night for it.
Oh. So is tomorrow gonna be better?
I don't know.
Is everything okay?
I'm not 13 anymore.
I know.
I was really good at 13.
Everyone's good at 13, Neil. It's just practice.
Well, I hope I got enough of it.
You wouldn't be doing what you're doing now if you got enough of it then.
I suppose it's not very natural, though.
I don't really care.
That's why I love you.
Hey, hey. Where the shit are you guys? It's almost midnight.
back, son.
Because it is there. Well, space is there. And we're going to climb it. And the moon and the planets are there. And new hopes for knowledge and peace are there. And therefore, as we set sail, we ask God's blessing on the most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked.
Is that you? Dad!
Whoa! Hold on there, cowboy. This is expensive moon gear I'm wearing. Wonder when I have to repair this, baby. It cost $1 million.
Sorry. You're here.
And so are you.
So what are you doing?
What's that?
I said, what is it you're doing, exactly?
Oh, this? Well, this is just moon stuff.
What kind of moon stuff specifically?
Oh, you know.
No, I don't.
Just your everyday moon stuff.
Huh.
I was doing moon stuff over there earlier. Got a little rough, so I moved on over there. And I'm probably gonna do some other moon stuff over that a ways later.
Uh-huh. Getting married, Dad.
That's great.
Having a baby, too.
You have a baby? That's wonderful.
Hey, you think maybe you could finally come back home now?
you know, and be a part of all this, I don't really know what I'm doing.
Go home?
Yeah, I built a ship and everything.
You built a ship? That's great. I built a ship once.
I copied your design.
Cool. Well, I got a lot of other moon stuff left to do. Can't stand around here talking all day.
Right.
Hey, you need a job?
Here?
Yeah. I got another moon box over there. Heck, both of us going, we get double the moon stuff done.
Why'd you leave, Dad?
Moon stuff.
Stop saying moon stuff. Dad? Dad, where'd you go? Dad, you can't leave. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Were you afraid of me growing up?
Arm's on fire.
You can't just run away from things. I'm an adult now, Dad, and I wish, you know, sometimes I wish I could be like you and hide from stuff, but you can't. I can't just do moon stuff. Dad, where are you? Dad, you can't leave. I don't know what to do. Oh, that's right, just walk away. You're good at that.
Neil. Neil?
Hey.
What the hell were you thinking?
I wanted to see if it would work.
Is he okay?
I'm okay.
Damn it, Neil. You said it wasn't supposed to do anything.
It wasn't supposed to do anything. But it did.
What exactly happened?
I did it.
Did what?
I went to the moon.
Are you messing with me? Or have you had a concussion?
I'm okay.
I don't get it, Neil.
Well, the spaceship didn't work. But it did. Because I went to space and I saw my dad.
Well, I'm glad you made it back. I want to hear about everything.
Where's the Campari?
What should we do with it?
much do you think it's worth?
Depends on how you market it, I guess. Probably do pretty well as a children's playset.
It's not really that safe.
You're not gonna do anything with it. You're gonna take it down, put it back in the garage, put some sheets over it.
For someone else to find?
That's the idea.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
I like it.